Makes sense.
Never know what the puzzle witch doesn't know anymore.
What's going on here, Kirk?
We are trying to help this woman, Captain Clara. Be quiet, or you'll put her and my science officer both at considerable risk.
He's trying to make a mental slave of the alien, Captain. She could tell him the secrets of this ship, of its transit through the Klingon Empire.
Oh, brother.
Stop him.
We'll listen in a moment. I wouldn't have a representative of the Federation damage or rendering assistance.
Puzzlewit remembers.
Yeah, he's interfering.
Everything she reads. Subject. Screen laminates. Reflective. Subject to autotrophic bonding with molybdenized nitrous oxides. In the presence of cyanodiphosphotrihydrous gases.
I don't know what that stuff is.
Subject. Wiring systems. Auxiliary to cryptolog.
Does Puzzlewit remember this ship passing through Klingon space, perhaps?
All the paralenses were copied prior to liftoff. No new encryption was permitted. We could only read, not write to them.
That stellar ejector, Captain. Why would a computer terminal permit read-only interface, I ask you?
The builders didn't trust us. Didn't think we would be capable.
These guys need to go here.
We were the damaged.
The builders.
Now, the reader is damaged. It's broken like Puzzlewit. Like us all. Like Tusken. Paralens can't be replaced. The reader can't be fixed. Puzzlewit can't be fixed. Nothing to read now. Nothing new to learn, to remember. Stupid. Like Tusken now.
This whole thing is stupid, if you ask me.
Yeah, huh?
Anything but stupid, in fact. Captain Kirk, the library this woman read has been recorded entirely in her mind, although she lacks the ability to understand it or even to recall it in an orderly manner. She believed if she could fill up her mind, acquire enough knowledge, understanding would come. Now her personality is withdrawing, refusing to accept the loss of everything she has not yet been able to read. She pinned all her hopes on this. And without it, she may lose the will to live.
Wow.
Do you know everything she knows now?
No, Captain Clara. I do not. This race has very unusual mind patterns, and I am fortunate she was in as passive a state as she is mentally. It is very likely I would have been hurt were she less withdrawn to begin with. Moreover, the knowledge she does possess is a very peculiar admixture, reflecting this society's uneven level of advancement. Archaisms and startling breakthroughs coexist.
So there is much to be learned from this woman, and from this ship.
Knowledge the Federation would gladly share with friends, Captain Clark.
Let nothing happen to this alien woman, Captain. If
she
should die, I would take it as an indication that you would sooner let her perish than share her special knowledge with the Klingon Empire.
Captain Clark.
No threats.
If I took her aboard the Enterprise, I might be able to help her.
I would have expected such treachery from the likes of you. You'll start an interstellar incident like this.
Sheesh.
I thought some of the folks on board this ship were paranoid.
Gentlemen, gentlemen. Captain Clark, we don't want this woman to die any more than you do. Not because we want to milk her brain dry, but because she's an important being in her own right.
Right.
Just as important to the universe as, well, as your companion here. Maybe more so. Dr. McCoy will do what he can. That's all that can be expected.
That's all I would expect. Goodbye for now, Captain. Expect to see us again.
Yay. I am awash with anticipation. Well, that was a long cutscene.
She appears to be cataleptic, Jim. No response to outside stimuli, a total lack of voluntary motor responses.
Can you do anything for her bones?
On the ship, maybe. The tricorder can tell me a little more, of course. country doctor's bedside manner can only go so far.
There is no response at all. Not even a flicker of attention crosses the person's eyes.
Well, I was hoping her, I might say something. I try this?
Evidently, this was an electronic device, almost certainly a reader or computer interface. It is severely damaged beyond any repair.
We appreciate your desire.
Yeah.
Captain, if this device was a person, I'd be signing the death certificate.
Yeah.
We appreciate.
Yeah, you appreciate.
Captain, I've seen designs for similar devices in my studies. Although only the Malefide Institute on Karabidi 3 is pursuing research into this methodology, it's actually quite advanced. This is a reader decryption device and mated computer terminal. The best data medium to date has been sheeted diamond, actually.
Really?
A thin construct of the highly consistent lattice makes the data encodable at the molecular level. Unfortunately, the medium is fragile and expensive.
I'm glad you've kept up on your technical journals, Lieutenant. Is this machine repairable?
I'm afraid it's terminal, Captain.
Wow. That's like... That, by itself, is like probably more lines than she's had through the rest of this entire game and the previous game. I guess it's the same here.
We appreciate.
Yep.
There is no response.
Alright, so there's nothing we can do otherwise, right? This isn't a door. Nothing else to see here.
No effect.
Nothing to get.
No
right?
effect. No effect. No effect. No effect.
Alright, we can't take anything.
Save new game. Replace pre-
We'll go back in the other room. Unless we can go... Unless this is to another room. Oh, it is. Cool. I love exploring places like this.
The room is filled with the rich scent of growing things. There is much lush growth, and some which is not thriving as well. A gardener's work table is against one wall.
So some kind of, Oh,
we
God.
We are just here to look around, Captain. I'm sure you don't mind.
Would it matter if we did?
Your doctor's discourtesy, though indirect, does no credit to your party.
They run in here.
I would have expected better when we have done nothing to warrant rudeness.
We need not interfere with one another's activities, I think.
They're just following us all over. They're not bright enough to make observations on their own.
A Klingon crewman wearing a look of disdain and distrust. A Klingon officer whose direct and intense expression never wavers. Captain Kirk, leader, finds this room particularly green. The Vulcan raises an eyebrow when he catches McCoy grinning at him, but atypically holding his tongue.
Yeah.
Bones eyes the Vulcan and wonders if, along with green blood, he might have a green thumb. Lieutenant Uhura seems to find this garden a pleasant place. The room is filled with the rich scent of growing things. There is much lush growth, and some which is not thriving as well. A gardener's work table is against one wall. The room is filled. These plants look green and healthy, with strong stems and shiny leaves.
This one is dead.
These plants look brown, pinched, and wilted, although their root systems are as well developed as those in the other hydro bins. Attached is a sealed metal keg with a feeder hose attachment on top. A trace of greenish mold rims the connection joint. A sealed metal keg with a feeder hose attachment on top. A trace of greenish mold rims the connection joint. The room is filled. A large countertop, well suited as a workbench, with what appears to be mechanized assists and a hookup close at hand. A small data terminal seems to be part of the design. A large countertop, well suited as the ceiling supports a complex network of pipes with vines growing between them.
I hate to do anything here because these guys are gonna, like, interfere.
A large countertop, well suited as
this reminds me of the Arboretum on Calliope 3, except the equipment didn't look this advanced.
This might be a nice little garden if they added some rustic wooden benches and a little fountain, I guess.
And if they got rid of the Klingons.
A hydroponics room, Captain. The console against the wall appears to be a workbench.
A shame there aren't any flowers, Captain, but the lushness of the greenery is still very pleasant.
We can talk to these Klingons.
My aide and I are merely observing both you and conditions on this ship. Should I have an observation to share with you, I will certainly not hesitate to do so.
Oh, joy.
Why would I want to chit-chat you, you treacherous Federation snake?
yeah, analyze stuff.
A chlorophyll-based plant species. Minor evidence of opportunistic disease incursion, but that appears to be secondary to reduction in overall plant vigor. Various plants grown in a specialized, nutrient-rich medium. Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. A combination workspace and computer console, Captain, with robotic leads on the visible hookups. The data terminal appears to serve as data storage and analysis of materials put on the countertop. In short, I believe it acts as a gardener's assistant to anyone working on the plants in this room. I do detect some evidence of malfunction in one of the hookups, but I believe it would take the inestimable skills of someone like Commander Scott to track down the problem, much less repair it.
Are you saying it's broken?
Only a small part seems to be broken, something involving one of the feed lines. The rest of it appears to be in good order.
This is the same thing.
A combination workspace and computer.
Yep.
Save new game. Replace.
How about, well, I was gonna try something, but first.
I'm just a simple country doctor, not a magician. There are some things I just can't fix.
I just wanted you to analyze it with your tricorder, since this is a life form, right?
The ceiling is plastered on a titanium steel frame. The pipes are ionic copper.
Save new game. Replace.
Spock. Knockout. Guest.
Captain, I hope you are not suggesting I attack this Klingon. Neither verbally nor in an effort to render him unconscious. I also believe any attempt to mind meld with him would be inefficacious, to say nothing of being inappropriate.
Well, would it be okay with him then? I'm just
a living, breathing Klingon in the flesh.
He just scanned him.
Readings are normal, but before you get more than a moment's worth of readings, the Klingon captain notices and snarls.
At ease, Doctor. We don't want to start an incident here.
Nah.
Readings are normal.
At ease, Doctor. We don't.
Just in case that cost us points, let me just load up. Now we really don't have anything, right?
There is nothing on the work console. Proceed with your work. This console is prepared to scan items anytime you are prepared to use it.
In English, at that.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Being born on Earth in an agricultural district has prepared you to recognize when certain plants are not thriving. That definitely describes these plants. Not thriving.
Not thriving.
The stems are shrunken, the leaves yellowish, and many have fallen off. The plant clearly tried to set some kind of fruit, but the little blackish-green balls couldn't possibly qualify as becoming anything edible in the foreseeable future.
Blackish-green balls, huh?
These poor things look like they need something or they're going to die. Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this. Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this. Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this.
Sure about that?
What about the ceiling, Captain?
It's covered with vines. Can't you see it?
Captain, there's got...
All right, she's done.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Gonna open the keg thing.
The feeder hose comes free, and a mechanism pulls it out of the way. But a terrible stench rises out of the container, smelling like many things died in there long ago.
Like plants.
These plants look brown, pinched, and wilted, although they're... The room is filled with the rich scent of growing things.
Well, I hope that didn't do anything to us.
A veritable Garden of Eden.
Beware of serpents, Jim.
The ceiling looks interesting. No, I don't think that's necessary.
These don't look so good, Jim. I don't understand any of this, Jim.
Did I hit this?
I don't understand.
I was gonna analyze it.
No life form registration. Health reading zero. I don't understand any of this, Jim. My, there's a lot of pipes up there. Jim, I'm a doctor, not a diplomat, and this Klingon looks pretty healthy to me. I'm a doctor, not an animal trainer.
Animal trainer.
This Klingon looks healthy enough to me.
Okay, so we need a diplomat for this one and an animal trainer for that one. Is that because he growled?
Communications is my specialty, Captain. But I don't think I have anything relevant to say to this individual.
It's worth it to hear these lines.
Communications is...
Okay.
Something about this Klingon demands your attention and a certain degree of respect. Not that he's any less the enemy, you remain wary. Something about this Klingon makes you want to bust him square in the chops, but you restrain yourself, knowing that it is conduct unbecoming of a Starfleet officer.
Yeah, unfortunately. Alright, Spockaroo. What can you do?
These plants do not appear to be particularly healthy, Captain. I do not see the logic in that action.
There is nothing on the work console.
I do not see the logic in that action. Captain, these pipes support the water supply for the hydroponic system. We must not tamper with them.
Okay, can I get this dead plant?
No effect. No effect.
Can I get anything?
No effect.
Because then we can analyze it on this table.
No effect. No effect.
These numbers?
The room is filled.
Alright. Can we go this way? There's a lot of rooms. Oh, there's a king! And the Klingons have not followed us yet.
This individual appears somewhat elderly, but he holds his head proudly and his shoulders are thrown back.
He's got blocks.
He nods benignly at you and a yellowish crown slips down a little lower on his brow. He clenches a short silvery rod with a bulbous tip firmly in one hand.
Oh, I wanted to look at him.
This individual wears a placid expression as he piles one block atop another, playing quietly. The incongruous thing is that he appears to be a full-grown adult. Noticing that you're looking at him, he raises his arms to you with a hopeful look.
We can't pick you up. Yeah, I was looking at him.
An ordinary chair, originally similar to others in the room, except someone has nailed the legs onto a raised platform, increased the height of the back, widened the seat, and glued on broad and blocky arms. Bright paint in red and purple and gold gives it a garish appearance. You think it's meant to look impressive, but it just looks rather pathetic.
Red, purple, and gold, like, kind of like, royalty? There's another plant.
A plant.
Uh-huh.
A piece of cloth.
Cloth?
A piece of cloth.
Not looking at the cloth.
A simple sliding door of reasonable dimensions for a person to walk through. A book. This appears to be a room to sit or talk or relax. A kind of all-purpose living space.
Like a living room, there's stuff here.
This appears to be a room...
Oh, can't look at this?
This appears to...
Yeah, it's not. What's this?
This appears to be...
Blocks.
Multicolored blocks, suitable for a child to play with.
There's another plant.
A plant. This appears to be a room... It is a gridwork over a recessed lighting mechanism.
Oops.
This appears to be...
What's this?
A normal-looking switch. The Vulcan raises an eyebrow, finding the situation quite illogical. The captain wants to know what these people can contribute to his efforts to put a halt to this ship landing on the colony town. And he's dubious about what he sees in this room. Lieutenant Uhura shifts uncomfortably under the intense gaze of the elderly fellow on the throne-like chair.
He's saying something.
Bones seems to be thinking that the rather heavy individual sitting on the floor has the look of someone who has been emotionally deprived. Someone who would benefit from some closer contact with others.
Indeed.
This situation calls for a good diplomat or a good psychiatrist.
These two individuals may be able to tell us something, Captain.
Perhaps.
Captain, the man in that throne-like chair seems to be staring at me. Perhaps I should try to talk to him.
Looks like he's staring all over.
I'd like to examine these two individuals, Captain.
Okay. First, we will examine everything.
Statistically speaking, this adult individual is overly heavy for an average humanoid in his frame.
Yeah.
This individual appears to be typical of his race, perhaps somewhat elderly. The crown is made of paper.
Paper.
And the silvery rod he holds is wood wrapped with silver tape. This individual appears to be typical of his race. Perhaps somewhat elderly. The crown is made of paper. And the silvery rod he holds is wood wrapped with silver tape.
The ones that can shoot thorns at people?
Only three varieties of that plant can shoot thorns.
That's funny.
Nor do I detect that ability from this specimen.
Well, if you guys were looking at the screen, that was not what he was saying.
The tricorder detects cotton and a few other synthetic fabrics. Nothing out of the ordinary. Interesting. The plant does not register in the tricorder botany file, but it does suggest similarities to Algolian crocus.
Algolian crocus?
Affirmative, Doctor.
Same. How about the switch?
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain. Nothing unusual about that op-
General room?
There are a number of life forms to be found throughout the ship.
How about these blocks?
blocks are an unusual organic substance high in compounds of phosphorus, nitrogen, ammonia, and calcium. In this form, the chemicals are inert and make a practical non-toxic tool.
About the chair.
A simple construction of various metals and plastics, half a meter wide at the base. Arms have been added post-construction, as has the raised back and the base platform. Even the seat has been widened.
What, is the guy that big? What is this? I saw this.
A book.
A book. Analyze the book.
Bound paper records in an alien language, Captain.
Okay, he's analyzed everything.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Checking in.
I believe this person has reached adulthood physically, Jim. But brain activity scans suggest he may have suffered a failure to mature intellectually.
Indeed.
Remember, this is a new race, Captain. While these people are clearly humanoid, I may not have all the answers. This individual is a bit elderly, but not in too bad shape when you take that into account. He seems to be suffering some brain lesions that might be genetically linked. Nerve degeneration in the lower back.
Is that why the special chair?
I'm just a simple country doctor, not a magician. Captain, there's nothing I can do for this individual with what I'm carrying with me. This is hardly more than a first aid kit. And I would be very uneasy medicating people of an alien race about which I know so little.
It's worth a try.
Captain, there's nothing I can...
I guess we're gonna talk to them. What do I have?
A round metal keg with a feeder hose attachment on top.
Oh, I have no idea we took that thing. Alright. I thought we just removed it. Let's analyze that then.
Nothing unusual about that object, Captain.
Okay. Then we're done with that. Let us save.
Save new game replace.
Let's talk to these guys then.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Who are you?
Jakesy.
What can you tell me about this place, Jakesy?
Jakesy?
Can I play with the blocks, Jakesy? Can you smile for me, Jakesy? Is there something you want, Jakesy? What can you tell me about this place, Jakesy? Can I play with the blocks, Jakesy?
The sweet-faced adult shakes his head no.
Yeah. Oh. Let's put his arms up.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Who are you?
Jakesy.
What can you tell me about this place, Jakesy?
The sweet-faced adult shakes his head no.
That was not a yes or no question.
I'm Captain James...
Jakesy.
What can you tell me? Can I play with the blocks, Jakesy? Can you smile for me, Jakesy?
The sweet-faced adult shakes...
Can't smile either. We have one option left.
I'm Captain James T.
Jakesy.
What can you tell me about this? Is it something you want, Jakesy?
The sweet-faced adult.
Okay. Doesn't want stuff. Can I take this book?
I don't see how these can help us, Captain.
Nah. Let's talk to him.
Methinks you peasants should know your place.
Atrioli?
And speak only when royalty speaks first.
Well, that's not very helpful.
Nice.
What do we do? Give him a hug? You hug him
we
too?
We acknowledge your obeisances, but you be not more than a jumped up merchant. Think you money might buy position? Little man, get away from our royal personage.
I'm a jumped-up merchant.
I didn't know you had a green thumb, Jim.
I'm from Iowa, Bones. We've been farmers for centuries.
True.
I wonder if that's supposed to be a cape. taking a little time for the universal translator to work. The great horned oxen bellowed as the moon's eclipsed. The shining willow palms shuddered in the smoke.
You can never really do justice to poetry if you try to translate it literally.
That's true.
It's taking a little time for the universal translator to work. Santawa's law of planetary motion. All planetary orbits are ellipses, and...
identical to Kepler's or Storak's laws, I assume.
What's this thing?
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Away, varlet! What do you think you're doing?
Though quite evidently an adult in body, Jake C looks as stricken as any child. His eyes filling with fearful tears.
My blocks? Thought you were nice. More hugs? More soft and nice, please. Don't take blocks.
Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this.
Agreed. We didn't take them.
Captain, there's nothing I can do for this end. I don't understand any of this, Jim. What are we supposed to do about that? Gardening is definitely not my field, Jim. Gardening is definitely not my field, Jim.
Away, varlet.
Away, bumpkin! Or we will have you thrown in the dungeon.
Alright, so Kirk's a varlet, and McCoy's a bumpkin.
Captain, there's nothing I can do. I don't understand any of this, Jim.
What is up here? Is this anything?
This appears to be a room.
Alright.
A look of bliss lights up the soft features of this adult-sized child, and he gently shares a long hug with the lieutenant.
Soft?
Yeah. Yes, she is.
Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this.
What is she? A temptress? A wench?
No, beautiful one. You may not sit with me. Yet, I grant you permission to speak with me if you wish.
Yeah.
A charming plant, Captain. This is a strange place. Nobody seems capable of taking care of themselves, yet we have pieces of cloth like this that are perfectly clean.
Riddle wrapped in an enigma, Lieutenant.
Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this. Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this. A charming plant, Captain.
So we're gonna talk to him, huh? With... how do we...
What a noble-looking woman, you. Noble? You have my permission to speak.
Can we speak like this then?
You stand out remarkably.
Okay.
Bearing yourself like a queen. Yet these carls do not treat you as royalty. Surely you have royal blood flowing in your veins.
Bloodlines do not dictate who we listen to. We weigh a person's worth by their actions. My leader here is Captain Kirk, an admirable man. Speak with him.
Yes, good one.
My ancestors ruled in the lands of Kush and Timbuktu. We may speak as peers, you and I. Royalty recognizes royalty, does it not? Look on me and decide for yourself. You will know. Bloodlines do not dictate who we listen. My ancestors ruled in the lands of
Timbuktu.
We may speak as peers, you and I.
Oh, I am so glad to find another of royal blood. I am so tired of sitting here all the time, but whenever I leave, thralls and lesser folk plant their fundaments on the great throne, and that's just not acceptable. I know you'll mind the proprieties and not let anyone else sit on the throne. And now, I'll finally be able to go and get some rest.
Oh, he's getting up and leaving.